Now, the Bible does talk about it. The Bible does talk about it. 2 Thessalonians chapter 1, verses 8 and 9, the Apostle Paul said, flaming fire. Peter, in 2 Peter 2, 4, said he trust not the angels that see him, but cast them down to hell. James, in James chapter 3 and verse 6, said the tongue is set on fire of hell. The beloved apostle John. Somebody said, well, John, the beloved John, he just wrote John the love book and John 3:16, and he didn't tell. Oh, yes, he did. He wrote the book of Revelation too. And the book of Revelation, John said, whosoever was not found written in the book of life would be cast into the lake of fire. Jude, in the book of Jude, chapter 1 and verse 7, said that the inhabitants of Sodom and Gomorrah are present tense, suffering the vengeance of eternal fire. Ladies and gentlemen, hey, you ask us why we run buses? Because there's a hell. You ask us why we support missionaries? There's a hell. You ask us why we fast and we preach hard? There's a hell where people go and burn forever and ever according to this book. You say, I don't believe it. You don't believe the Bible. You're taking a chance nobody in Las Vegas would take. You've never been dead, and you don't know nobody who has been dead. The only other person who is an authority on it, who has been dead and come back, is the Lord Jesus Christ. And he told us that it's there. Jesus affirmed it. He said, how can you escape the damnation of hell? Mark 9:47, you'd be better off to go to hell with one eye than having two eyes to be cast into hell fire. Matthew 23 and verse 33. How can you escape? Luke 16 and verse 23. The Bible said the rich man lift up his eyes in hell. The Jehovah's false witnesses say that's a parable. Jesus never used personal names in a parable. There was a certain rich man, Lazarus, named him, and a beggar, or the rich man, and then the beggar named Lazarus, I'm sorry, and the rich man was rich, and Lazarus fed, ate the crumbs that fell out from under his table. Ladies and gentlemen, it was no parable. He said the field is the world. This is that. The seed is the word of God. And he explains what everything is, but when he gets to the fire, he don't say the fire represents something. He said the seed is the word. The world, the field is the world. When he gets to the fire, he don't say nothing. You know why? Because the fire is fire. Jesus affirmed it. Jesus Christ said there is a hell. There is no doubt about it. Matthew 16, verse 18, the Lord said, on this rock I'll build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail against it. Matthew 5 and verse 29 said, fear them which cannot kill the body, but after that have no more they can do, but fear him which can destroy both soul and body in hell. Hell is not the grave. Hell is not the grave. Are you listening to me? One man said, well, hell's just the grave. And they think they're smart because they went back in the Old Testament and found Gehenna and Sheol and Tartarus and Hades. And they get all confused. They don't even know the English. They sure don't need to be trying to study Hebrew and Greek. And the Hebrew teaches there's a hell. The Greek teaches there's a hell. And the English teaches there's a hell. The Bible teaches there's a hell. It is not the grave. See, the Lord said, fear not. Don't be afraid of somebody that can just kill your body and can't do nothing else to you. All they can do is kill you. But rather, you better be afraid of that one which after he's killed to cast you into hell. Now, it don't mean the grave. That'd be like me getting up here saying, now look, y'all, don't you worry about somebody can just kill you. Don't be scared of them. You some pallbearers you better watch out for. That's who you better be scared of, because they can take you and put you in the grave. If hell is not the grave. He ain't talking about no pallbearers. He's talking about God, which after you're dead, cast you into hell. Let me say secondly this morning, who will go to hell and why? Who will go to hell and why? The rich man died, the Bible said in Luke 16, he's in hell. He's in hell this morning. He was in hell when Columbus discovered America. He was in hell when they built the White House for our presidents to live in. In the days of George Washington, that rich man was still in hell. 2,000 years, he's still there this morning. Who will go to hell and why? Well, all who reject God's Son and the free gift of eternal life.